The story of my life, I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm in time. It's frozen. Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Alan. I just wanted to come along and say hello to you guys and see how you all are and to give you a quick update on my weighing update and just to kind of let you know what happened in group this week and how I got on those scales and what kind of things we were talking about this week and stuff like that and how as well I'm feeling about my result or whatever happened this week in group. Let me know how you all are. As you all know, I like doing these videos so I can talk to you and I hopefully can help you with some ideas in swimming world or some ideas and some support. Definitely, I hope these videos will help you either with some ideas or giving you some support on your journey. That's what I like to do in my videos. So let me know in the comments down below, as I've said probably a few minutes ago, on how you did this week. If you have been weighed in, let me know in the comments down below. Let me know how you all are in general. Let me know what's kind of going on and stuff like that. So for me, this week, there's a lot of stuff going on this week for me coming up this week. A lot of different things. So tomorrow on Monday I will be doing my 400 subscribers giveaway. I will be picking my 400 subscribers giveaway competition, if you want to call it a competition. So look out for that video tomorrow. It will go up on YouTube and one of you lovely YouTuber people who've subscribed YouTubers, one of you lovely subscribers will win that prize which I showed in the giveaway before. So I'm gonna do that tomorrow morning. I'm going to pick the winner. So tune into that video tomorrow. And as well this week, I have a few different things to do. As you all know, I do drama teaching. So again, do drama this week. And as well as that, I volunteer for the East Lancashire Railway, which is a heritage railway, which is basically steam trains and diesel trains. And it's basically, we kind of try and bring our customers back to the 1940s, the 1950s. So everything is very, very, very kind of in a different type of settings. The station looks very back in the 1950s. It's like stepping back into the 1940s and the 1950s and a little bit of the 1960s. So I have a meeting there this week, just about this year, because the station will be opening next month in February. I think it's open on the 10th of February and we have a big event going on and there's like a meeting this week about the event and things like that. Today I'm wearing my one of my uniforms. The kind of department I work with or volunteer work with on the East Lancashire Railway is train steward, so I look after the passengers and make their journey as happy and as enjoyable as possible, and I try to make their journey very, very safe, making sure everything is safe. So I am wearing one of my kind of uniforms. This is not exactly what I'd wear if I was a train steward, but there are different duties in the station and sometimes you gotta wear different things. So today I am wearing my hoodie, even though I'm not at the railway today. It's just that for me it is a very cold day here in Manchester. And it's very windy and we're going to be having a storm. So just they have been saying there's going to be a storm and things like that. I'm just going to have a quick cup of my coffee because I know I'm starting to get a little bit of a dry throat talking to you guys. And I definitely don't want that to happen. So I'm just going to have a quick cup of my coffee, which is in my mug. I like this mug. It's pretty cool. So there you go. Yeah, so excuse me. So you were saying that this week here in Manchester, especially in England, there is going to be like a storm. It's going to be very, very windy. We just had the snow and now we're going into a lovely new storm, which is like, for me, I'm like, oh, here we go, which is definitely, For me, with my leg, and because my left leg is very sore, I think I've explained that before, because of my stroke, and as well, there's been a few other extra things been happening to my left leg that needs to be seen. And I'm still waiting for an appointment with the hospital about different things that are going on. I don't really want to talk to go into it. I've gone into it a few times in some of my videos, and as well, so it's like for me, with the wind or with the snow, it's very difficult because I have to use my walking stick. So when I go out, I make sure I have to use my walking stick. And even though the walking stick can make me feel stable that I'm not going to fall, but I always have the fear that if I did fall, which has happened in the past, I have falls ever so often, and my fear is if I do have a fall and my walking stick goes, and if I land on my right hand, and I hurt my right hand or my wrist or my elbow, whatever, and then my right hand or my right arm is out of action, where does that leave me, because I can't use my left hand at all? So it does leave me in a bit of situation. So I am trying to keep away from the wind. I'm trying to keep away from any kind of storms or any type of bad weather. If I need to go to certain places, like go to drama or go to the railway, I have friends who will give me lifts there. Or if I have to, I will rely on a taxi or something just to get me there, just for my own self well-being, making sure that I don't get injured. Is the thing, isn't it? And I think we got to look out for our safety. I think that's the one major thing. We got to look out for our safety. So as I said, so I'm wearing my hoodie today because it is very cold outside and this keeps me really, really warm. And I know I should really wear it only when I'm in the railway, but if I'm doing a certain different type of job on the day. But I do like wearing it because it keeps me really warm. So I'm wearing it. So that's why I have it on today. And as well, I've just told you, I am going to the railway next week just for we're having a meeting and stuff like that. So yeah, so I'm just having it on because it's nice and snuggly. And I have my hood if I want to pull it up. And I have like pockets that I put my hands in, and I just, you know, it just feels really, really nice. So that's why I've got it on today, just to keep me nice and snuggly and nice and warm as it is cold and windy outside. So yeah, so I just wanted to kind of say, explain all that, and it is, that's, I've literally gone through, like, good God, stuff that you probably didn't want to hear. Information that you're like, Alan, we're here for your away day. We don't want to hear about all this craziness. But anyway, you know what I'm like? I love sharing the craziness. Whatever goes on in my life, I love sharing with you. At the moment, Boris is okay. My friends are taking Boris out later on for his body magic, or so to say, for his walk. At the moment, he is just down here in his bed asleep, all snuggly wuggly, all snuggled up like a little baby puppy. So he's down there and he's going out later on with my friends. They're going to be very good to come along and take Boris out. They've been doing that for me most of the week because it's a bit too difficult. I went out twice with Boris last week, but that for a very short kind of trip with him. So yeah. So that's what's happening with Boris. As well, this week Boris was supposed to get his haircut on Friday, last Friday, but it was very bad snow. So the person who cuts Boris's hair couldn't come out, because the way I get Boris's haircut, it's like, it's a dial-a-dog wash. So basically, it's this lovely lady, she's been here since he was a puppy, and she comes out, she has her own business, and basically it's dial-a-wash. Is that what I say? Yeah. And she has a van, and the van comes out. She takes him into the van and she gives him a pamper. She cuts his hair, she does his nails, which he doesn't really like getting done because he's very grumpy sometimes. So he gets his nails done and things like that, and gets his nice little haircut. So last Friday he was supposed to get it done, but she couldn't come out because the snow was really bad. So she's coming out to do his hair on Friday. This Friday. So that's another thing that's happening this week. So it's going to be exciting for Boris. He doesn't know yet that he's getting it done. He's not too great at getting his hair washed, getting his hair cut. What he enjoys when he gets in there, she said, when he gets into the van and she gets him relaxed and stuff like that, he's excited then. He's happy to get his hair cut. But before he gets to that point and getting a wash, he's like, no. So he doesn't know yet. So he's getting his hair cut this week, which then he looks so handsome. At the moment, he's looking a bit like a little bear. His hair is everywhere. And he looks like, yeah, just looks like a little bear cub, because his hair is everywhere. It's all grown a bit long and stuff like that. So he looks a bit funny. But, you know, but just to let you know, he is down there and he's chilling out. Like we all are. Chilling. I hope he's all sitting back chilling out. And I hope he's all sitting there having a cup of coffee or a cup of tea or some type of drink, sitting back and enjoying the video. So I'm going to have a quick cup of my coffee again, and I'm going to get on to my weighing update and then a few other things before I get there, and then that be that. So, you know, so have a quick sup. I really love a cup of coffee. It's really nice, especially on a day like this. Another thing actually this week I've started to have more of since Friday is hot lemon water. And I've been really enjoying that actually. Before I forget to tell you, yeah, so this week, just since Friday, I've been starting to have loads of hot water with lemon in it, cut up, and it's really, really nice. I used to love it, and then I stopped taking it, I stopped drinking it, and I'm back on it now, and it's really, really nice. Very refreshing. And again, it's something nice to have when it's cold outside. So definitely, I'm back on that, and it's really, really nice. So I just wanted to say that as well, just in case I forget, because you know what I'm like? I forget things. I'm very forgetful. I am. So, mindfulness jar. Our mindfulness kindness jar. Let's get to this. And it's just, the link is just falling off. So, self-kindness, little saying. And there's the jar, because it just fell off. I did pick the saying, as I do in the morning time. And I'm going to share it with yous. And yeah, let me know in the comments down below how you feel about this saying. And I'll read it out to you and then I'll talk to you. So it says, heart. Take a moment to take a deep breath. Put your hands on your chest. Relax and think about someone you can be grateful for. So I'll read it again to you without making a mistake. Heart. Take a moment to take a deep breath. Put your hand on your chest. Relax and think about someone you can be grateful for. So there is, I'm just gonna do that. There is the saying. Hopefully this will focus. It probably won't, knowing my look. You see? Hopefully. So, it says, as it says, put your hand on your heart, take a deep breath, and think of someone that you're grateful for. So shall we all do that? So let's all sit back, let's put our shoulders up, you know, put them up. And one thing that we do in drama, to relax yourself, especially if you put your shoulders up, now drop them, so everybody drop them. Roll your shoulders really slow, one side, and I can't really do it properly on the other side, but we'll try. So kind of roll your shoulders. Now put your hands down to your side, take a deep breath, and release it. Now, shall we do what the saying said? So it says, put your hand on your chest, close your eyes, take a deep breath, and think of someone that you're grateful for. So this is going to look weird on video, but if we're all doing it together, I won't look the silliest person doing it, okay? So if we all do it together, hopefully you all will, I won't look as silly as I feel, okay? So let's do it. Let's put our hand on our chest. Let's close our eyes, take a deep breath, and let's think of that person or people or whoever you're grateful for. And let's open our eyes very slowly and come back to the room. There you go. There you go, guys. I hope that has helped. We've slowed everything down and we've had a little bit of relaxation. Let me know in the comments down below if that has helped you in any way. And let me know the person or whatever it is that you're grateful for. What I was thinking of when I did it was my mum. As people know here on my channel, my mum passed away 2 years ago now, and that saying there just reminds me of her, because I am so grateful that she was a part of my life, and I'm so grateful that she was always there for a chat, for a talk, for a hug, and for all those nice things that mums are there for. And as well as that, it brings me to, I'm grateful for me especially, my family. My dad, my brother and sister, my niece, and everybody that are in my family. So it kind of has brought me to think about a lot of lovely memories, and exactly, you know, what life is all about, what we're here for, and who we do these journeys for. So for me, I do my weight loss journey for my health, first of all, but as well as that, I used to do it for my mum, to, because she always was worried about my weight, especially after having two strokes, when I was younger, and then another stroke when I was like older, which was a few years ago, which was a very small stroke, it wasn't the biggest. So she used to worry about my weight, because I couldn't do a lot of things, my weight went up, and definitely she was always concerned over that. So I would do my journey on my weight loss journey for her, as well as that I would do it for my father, because as I said, like my mum, I think it's that thing of parents, they have this thing of no matter what age they are, no matter what age you are, they still worry about you, they still care about you, there's always whatever. Like, you know, my dad, you know, as I said, my mum, when she passed away, she was in, I think she was like 78. And then my dad, who's still knocking around, he's still around, he's still here. And he is 81 now, going on 82 this year. And when I ring home to tell him how I got on in the swimming world, if I ring up and tell him about how I'm getting on generally, he still worries about me. And it's that thing of like, like he did say to me a few weeks ago, he goes, you're my son, I do not stop being concerned, I'm still your father. It doesn't stop that concern, that worry, or even that unconditional love. Doesn't stop when you get older, it's there. It's there for you, and you know, you just don't stop thinking about and thinking for the best for your children. And so, you know, so as I said, for me, doing that exercise, doing that relaxation, that kindness exercise for myself, it reminded me of my mum, it reminded me of my father, or my dad I should say, it reminded me of my brother and sister, it reminded me of my niece, and reminded me of those lovely things that mean a lot to me. And as well, give me the energy and gives me the spark to keep going on my journey, and just as well, just to keep me kind of keep going, and not let things get you down, or not let anything, you know, whatever. Like, there's one thing that a few years ago when I did my channel, my niece Erin was over, and we did a video. She was really, really young at the time, and we did a video. I think she was like 8 or 9, and we did a little video, and she really enjoyed it. So we did like an unboxing, because on my channel I used to do a lot of unboxing, kind of geek boxes and other types of things like that. I used to do a lot of that, and she kind of did an unboxing of some kind of stuff that she liked, toys, and there was a few other different things that she liked at the time. And she did a video, and I was like, you know, you've done better than me, because, you know, because when I was doing these videos at the time, I wasn't doing YouTube that long. Even though I've been doing it a good few years now, I still haven't got a clue basically how to do YouTube properly. and I just don't. I hold my hands up to it. I'm not the best person at YouTube. How it works, how it goes, how it does. I just like recording my journey, recording my diary, and sharing with yous all, and kind of hopefully helping yous guys out there, and having a bit of a chat, having a bit of a conversation, having a bit of, you know, there's loads of things. So at Christmas, Erin was telling me that she actually, because she plays violin, she started playing violin a few years ago. She's 14 now, which I can't believe. She's grown up, and I feel really old. But yeah, she's 14 now, and she has been playing violin for the last few years, which is absolutely amazing. And in February this year, she is going to be in the National Concert Hall in Dublin. And she's going to be playing with her orchestra. And she is, I have to get this right, she's not head violinist, she's first violinist, which is she's the person that everybody follows. She's the, you know, first violinist, I think it's called. So she's the main violinist of the orchestra. And it's a really big achievement. And yeah, and you know, I'm so proud of her, and you know, things like that essay and kind of brought all those memories back as well, those thoughts. So yeah, so first violinist, that's what she's going to be in the National Concert Hall this February. Unfortunately I can't get over to see her because I'd love to, but I can't get back in February to see her. But that's just a little bit, hopefully my sister said she might be able to record it and I may be able to see it. But at Christmas time, I was saying to her, oh, you have to play the violin. And she's like, you know, as I said, she's 14. And as I said, I think she's absolutely amazing at what she does. And I'm so proud of her. As an uncle, I'm absolutely proud of her in every little way you could be. And so she did a little piece of violin. This was her first time playing this piece of music. And I said, can I record it? And she was like, okay, you can. So I recorded her playing it, and it was lovely because the Christmas tree was up. It was lovely setting, you know, the room looked lovely, and she was sitting there playing this piece of music that I think she got that piece of music that week, and she kind of looked over it, but she didn't really play it properly that well. She didn't get a lot of time to practice playing it, I should say, or going through it or learning it. So she just got out the music sheets and she sat there and she played this piece of music. Now I thought, and I just thought it was so beautiful. And I did ask her, I asked her today, if I do this video and I tell people out there on YouTube about my YouTube friends, I said to her, about everything like that, about what she did, could I show this video to you? So she said to me, yeah, you can. So at the end of this video, please stay around at the end of this video when I say goodbye to you, and have a look at Erin playing her violin, because I think for someone who plays the violin, and she's only 14, and she's only been doing about, I think, like three and a bit years, and she this was the first time she really played this piece of music to anybody, and she hadn't got this piece of music for long. So I will share that with you because I think it's absolutely brilliant and I'm so proud of her. So stay around for that piece of music. Don't turn off and move on before you get to see it. And let me know in the comments down below what you think of her music and how she played the song, because I think it was absolutely brilliant. But anyway, so weigh day. I'm going to get my quick cup of coffee and then I'll tell you my weighing update. And then I'll end the video because I think I am waffling on as usual. So it's not unusual for me to waffle on, is it? So it's just like, not. And you all know me now, so you know exactly what you're gonna get when you come to my channel, Alan yapping away, and then you know, just telling you everything that's going on. So when I went to group and I stood on those scales, last week I had a few rocky days with kind of having trying to get my snacking down at night time, so I was a bit concerned over that, which you probably all know with my videos. I did get a grip on it, halfway through the week and I was okay. So there was like one or two days that I was a bit not off plan, but you know what I mean? Like I couldn't get a hold on my treat, you know, my snacks at night and eating through the night. Well, through the evening time, I should say. So when I stood on the scales, I had, and I was so happy, and you're probably gonna see it by my face, I'm really, really happy. I've got a smile on my face because this week I had a maintain. So a maintain to me, as a lot of YouTuber people say, and I've said in the past, I'm on the maintain train. So I'm really, really happy with my maintain this week. It was something that I wasn't expected. I was expecting a little bit of a gain, but to be on the maintain train, it's fantastic. And I'm really, really happy that I'm there this week. I know exactly what I'm doing this week on plan. The only thing I have, as I said before, I have a bit of a busy week. But as well, on Thursday, I'm going out for my friend's birthday. He is 42 this week, which is getting old. But then saying that, I'm 48 this year, so that's not really great, is it? You know, I shouldn't be making fun. I'm 48 in April, so that's not going to be good, is it? I'm getting nearer to the 50 mark, but hey, yo, what can you do? So yeah, so I'm going out on Thursday with all my friends for a meal. I'm going to look at the menu and I'm going to see what good choices I can make for the Thursday. So that's what I'm going to try and do. So I am planning my week as much as I can. I've done my food diary, food planner, I should say, for the week. So I know what food I'm having. I'm looking forward to what food I'm having. And yeah, so I'm doing pretty okay. So I know exactly what I'm doing. And as I said, I was pretty happy to get maintained. I'm not disappointed with that at all. And yeah, as you can see from my face, I'm really happy. So that smile is a bit weird. My friends always say, if anyone out there has seen the film Wallace and Gromit, which is a cartoon film, Joe say you smile like Gromit, which is, and he kind of has this very cheesy smile. So he's like, so a lot of people say I smile like that. So I apologize. So in group as well, I got a 12-week countdown because I find it easier because it can keep me on plan. I got my new Slimming World book, which is Food for the Soul, and it looks, some of the food in here looks lovely. So I'm gonna try, maybe not this week, but I am gonna try some of these recipes. I'm gonna see if I can find, so you've got in here Scotch eggs. So you've got like, there you go, it's a nice little picture there. And yeah, and it has some other nice stuff. Let me see. Beef, this pie looks really, really nice. I might give this one a go. I think it looks really nice. That looks fantastico. So I may give that one a go. Not yet, but sometime. Yeah, there's absolutely millions and loads of lovely recipes in here. So I'm going to put it down because I'll just be looking at it and use it all here going, he's looking at it. Why is he not talking to us? Oh yeah, so there you go. So that's that. Now in group this week, our consultants, we were talking about trying to, you know, see the end of the road. So, you know, sometimes we set ourselves a target and we go, we want to get there, but how are we going to get there? But we need to see it. How can we see that target? How can we see where we're going? So this week she gave everybody this, which I thought was a very good idea. And it's a piece of paper and it has your stone award, your half a stone award, your stone award, stone a half, 10. All these, I'll show it to you from this angle. So it's all the stickers that you would get. And it's all the way up to 4.5 stones. So she said, if you put this on the fridge, right, she said, even though you haven't got any of these, if you haven't got any of these awards, she said to the group, if you haven't got any of these awards, don't worry about it. Put that on your fridge. And every day you can look at that, even though you don't have the certificate, and you can go, you know what, I'm going to aim for my half a stone award. And you know it's there. And by seeing it on a piece of paper, sometimes it can give you kind of, that's what I want to get. it can make you real. It can make you focus on where you want to go. And she said you can pick whatever goal you want, even though if you haven't had a target in your book yet, or you have got a target in your book, you can just kind of see, you can actually see where your target's going to be. So you can see where the road, where it is, and how we can get there, you know, slowly. So she gave us one of these. Now, I thought it was a great idea. So she says she gave it up to 4.5 stones. She said if anybody wanted more than that, like further up, she goes, she'll give people the piece of paper with the stars on it. So I thought that was a really good idea, because if you can see it, you know where you want to be. And, you know, and she says, when you get whatever certificate you get, you can go down to the piece of paper here, and you can get a pen, and you can tick it off, write your date, then put that back on the fridge, and then you can make a plan for your next certificate or your next certificate. And I just thought it was a really, really, really nice idea from her. I just thought it was really, really nice, and definitely that's going on my fridge, because I know where I want to be. I'm not going to share it on TV, on YouTube at the moment. TV, what am I? This is not the BBC, Alan. This is YouTube. So yeah, so I'm not going to share it on YouTube where I want to be, but I will put a little mark on whatever certificate I want to get, because I want to get back down. Because as I said in this channel before, I did lose 6 stone, and I want to kind of get back down to where I was, and that was like a happy place for me. I felt really happy that way. My leg felt happy that way. I didn't have much more. I felt much more mobile. And much more, my joints didn't feel as in pain. So as I said, that was a bit weird, wasn't it? So she gave us that, and I think that was a great idea, and everybody loved it. And so that's going on my fridge, and I'm going to mark where I want to be, and the certificates I have got, I'm going to give them a click, and I'm going to put a date and stuff like that on it, and leave it on the fridge, just to help me. So yeah, there you go, guys. As I said, I wanted to make a quick video, and I've waffled on, I think, for a half an hour. So, as I said, tomorrow I'm doing my giveaway. So, good luck to everybody who has entered that giveaway. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments down below how you all are. Let me know what you think of this video. Have you enjoyed this video? Let me know what's coming up in your week. What is anything going to be? Is something coming up that's going to make life a struggle, or is there something just like in general, and you might want some advice on how to plan to deal with that situation. So guys, as I said, I've said it before, do my video tomorrow, my giveaway. So as I always say to these guys, if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and until tomorrow, be kind to yourself and have a great week. Bye.